Good morning. I think this morning of the verse, as I hear everyone chattering, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And we want to welcome you in this morning to worship, to fellowship with one another, to be encouraged, to be the body of Christ. Will you stand as we get, will you stand and sing with us today? Praise the Lord, sing hallelujah. It calls on all of us to give our praises.
Praise the Lord, sing hallelujah, from the heavens praise his name. Praise the Lord, our great creator, all the angels praise proclaim. All his hosts together praise him, sun and moon and stars on high. Praise the Lord.
Country team competed in state tournaments this week, and yesterday the boys qualified as a team and Jesse qualified individually. So congratulations to coaches Rosses and the team and the runners for their hard work this season. Another announcement, as you see there are shoeboxes up here, those will be collected next Sunday, so you've got one more week to continue working on your boxes and get them in. Another announcement that's in the bulletin, just to draw attention to, there is an opportunity this morning to sign the covenant if you would like to do that and you have not signed our annual covenant renewal or signed for the first time. That is on this side of the sound booth here. The bulletin describes it as the north side. If you grew up somewhere that doesn't orient that way, it's on this side. We didn't do that in Ohio. We didn't talk about north and south because nothing went that way. I think that's all I have in the way of announcements. There are several other in your bulletin. Pay attention to those. Lots of prayer requests in your bulletin as well. One additional announcement or prayer request I was given this morning, just to be aware, add Linda Hoberton to your prayer list. She is experiencing a lot of pain again. She has a doctor's appointment Tuesday morning in Mount Pleasant with the rheumatologist that she saw previously, just looking for some answers to finding the cause for her pain. She's in a lot of pain. So Frank and Linda ask that you remember them and do so, just that they can, with God's help, get some answers and get some relief. Unless there is something else, let's have a word of prayer as we continue on in our service. Lord, we come today, and we know that you are our Father, and that you love us, and that you care for us. We care for one another here too, and we bring you the concerns that mount up and the things that weigh us down, and we just ask that you would minister to those needs, that your will and your kingdom would rule and reign over all of the concerns that are listed in our bulletin. In particular, we think this morning of Linda and Frank as they are looking for answers for the pain that is in her body. We just ask for your healing touch, your wisdom, your strength to be upon all. Lord, there are many things that distract us, and we just want to take the time this morning to put those aside, that we may focus today on you, on your gift of salvation for us, your love and redemption for us, for the many ways that you bless us time and time again. God, we come together as your people today. We come as a praising people, singing your goodness. We come as a hungry people, longing to be fed. We come as a praying people, bringing our needs and our joys. We come as a journeying people, looking for direction. In this hour of worship, empower us for faithful living. We pray this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. In the Old Testament, Psalm 47, verses 6 to 9, sing praises to God, sing praises, sing praises to our King, sing praises. For God is the King over all the earth. Praise him with a psalm. God reigns above the nations, sitting on his holy throne. The rulers of the world have gathered together with the people of the God of Abraham. For all the kings of the earth belong to God. He is highly honored everywhere. The New Testament tells us in Philippians 2, therefore God elevated him, referring to Jesus, to the place of highest honor and gave him the name above all other names, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue declare that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Will you stand and let's honor and praise the name of Jesus. All hail the power of Jesus' name.
Crown him, crown him, crown him.
every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, they sang, "Blessing and honor and glory and power belong to the one sitting on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever."
With many crowns, the Lamb upon the throne, are called the heavenly anthem, drowns all music but its own. Awake, my soul, and sing of Him who died for me, and hail Him as the matchless King.
Thy praise shall never, never fail throughout eternity. All praise to our wonderful, merciful Savior.
Wonderful, merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend, who would have thought that a
Spirit, we long to embrace.
morning, and we thank you for the healing and grace, for the gift of salvation, and your steadfast love to us. We praise your name always. Amen. You may be seated, and the children can make their way up for children's time with Jubal.
Some cool sunglasses, Amelia. My stack of stuff keeps getting bigger every week, I feel like. So, this morning, we're going to be talking about the Bible, if you can imagine. Kind of what we talk about, isn't it? So this morning, though, we're going to be talking about specifically how to read stories in the Bible. Kind of. So do any of you guys have you ever heard of a thing called a superhero? Any of you? Have you, Abram? Who's your favorite superhero?
Batman.
There we go. What about you, Elizabeth?
The Flash.
Okay. Okay, so have any of you ever had your parents or you yourself read a story about a superhero? You have? They can be kind of crazy sometimes, right? Like they do all these wild and crazy things. Maybe they can fly or they throw a batarang or something like that, right? They can do all these wild and crazy things in these stories. And so sometimes when we read the Bible, we can think that the Bible is telling us stories like Batman because they can do some wild and crazy things in the Bible, but that's not really how the Bible is. And so we're going to talk about, if we want to get the slide up, maybe some comparison that we need to be worried about taking, because we can kind of glorify some of the stories in the Bible in a way that makes them seem unreal when they actually are real and did happen. So the book says, heroes are cool. Who doesn't enjoy the Avengers or Batman, Spider-Man, or any of them? They have awesome costumes, sweet vehicles, secret identities, hidden bases, and amazing abilities. Yet, most of them are also flawed people with broken pasts who have risen to face those challenges for the good of others. What's not to like? But when you stop to think about why you like heroes, the answer is clear. God made you that way. He created you to appreciate and imitate someone greater than yourself. We are all wired for worship. There's just something that draws us to admire people who have power, looks, money, and influence. And when you go to the Bible, its pages are filled with incredible characters. When you read the Bible, don't simply try to act like the people in the stories. God isn't telling us about a bunch of heroes who always come through to save the day. Instead, he's showing how he is the hero who rescues people who do both good and bad things. For example, have any of you guys heard the story David and Goliath? All right. So when you read about David and Goliath, remember that David, the boy who would be the king one day, fights on behalf of the entire army of Israelites who are too scared to go into battle. The Israelites were too scared to go, and a little boy had to go fight for them. That's pretty crazy, right? Yet, this story is written not so you could be like David, the king, but so that you would learn to trust a king who would fight for you. And so it happened that years later, another king, who we would call Jesus, would wage war in the place of God's people against their greatest enemies, sin, Satan, and death. Whether in David's day or the time of Jesus, God has always sent a deliverer to rescue his weak and sinful people. And this deliverer, not David, is a real hero. And that hero is Jesus. And that's how we need to look at the Bible when we're reading it, is focusing on, okay, how was God and Jesus working through this story to teach us what we need to know. Next week, we'll continue with a little more detail on how we read stories in the Bible. But let's say a word of prayer, and we'll head back to our seats, all right? God, we thank you for this morning, for the time that we can look into your word. I pray that you would just be with these kids as they get older and learn to read your Bible and have parents and family and friends who are willing to speak the Bible into their lives. I pray that they would always look to see how you are working, God, and how they can trust you as the King. And I pray that all of us would act in such a way that we would look to you for everything that we need. And we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you guys can head back to your seats.
Before Jubal comes for part four of Spiritual Gifts, I was drawn to and reminded this week of a song that may be unfamiliar to many of you, but you're going to learn it with me today. There are many gifts, but the same Spirit. It's number 304 in your blue worship book if you want to take a look there. But it goes through exactly what we've been talking about, that we are a body, and we have lots of gifts, and we need to use them together. Just stand and sing with us, please.
Many gifts, but the same Spirit. There are many works, but the same God. And the Spirit gives each as it chooses. Praise the Lord, praise God. Now one has a gift of wisdom, another the calling to speak, one the ability comfort, another the calling to teach. There are many gifts, but the same Spirit. There are many works, but the same God. And the Spirit gives each as it chooses. Praise the Lord, praise God. A body has many members, same Spirit. There are many works, but the same God. And the Spirit gives each as it chooses. Praise the Lord, praise God. Not all are called to be prophets, and not all are called to preach, but all should aim for the best gift. Same Spirit, there are many works, but the same God. And the Spirit gives each as it chooses. Praise the Lord, praise God.
Maybe seated, Jubal.
Morning. You responded, so you must be able to hear me. That's a good start. All right, if you want to open up to Romans chapter 12, again, we'll be continuing our trudge through that. I know the youth group guys are thinking we're moving a little fast. We've gone through three verses in 4 weeks, so upstairs, I don't know if we get through quite that many, but for you guys, we move a little quicker. But before we dive too deep into that, I just, as usual, have a few different announcements that I wanted to go over. As I've said, we are planning on doing a baptism in November, so if we have anyone interested in doing that, please get with one of the elders, myself, or any of the others for that. Another plug for the Spiritual Gifts class. I think that's something really important, and so I keep wanting to emphasize that. So if you're interested in that, I know it has been going a few weeks now, but don't let that stop you from getting into it. If that's something you're feeling, you know, pushed to do, talk to to Warren. I know he's leading the class upstairs, or I believe Lowell has started a midweek class now, and so you can talk with them or any of the elders to try and jump into one of those, because we want you plugged into something like that if that's something you feel led to do. And finally, there, as a reminder, if you couldn't smell it, there's a potluck and an annual meeting in the basement after the service today. So we invite anyone to feel free to stay for that. And if you desire also to help discuss the different topics and things of the meeting, but if not, feel free just to come for the potluck and take off after that. If you didn't get an agenda and wanted to stay for the meeting, either check your mailbox, or I believe there's a stack in the back as well for those. And finally, as Rochelle mentioned, there is a sign-up. I think we're going to look to doing that during communion time, but a sign-up if you desire to be a covenant member for the church. We're looking at doing that as a monthly thing available for anyone who didn't get to do it during the annual setup due to being out for any reason. So that's available back there, and Lowell will be manning it if you have any questions for him. But with that, let's get into chapter 12 and to the meat of what I wanted to talk about this morning. So we'll be reading again verses 6 through 8. And this today we'll be kind of finishing actually the end of verse 8. But I wanted to read the whole thing again just to keep a focus on where we've been at with this spiritual gifts discussion. So 6 starts, "We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is giving, then give generously. If it is to lead, do it diligently. If it is to show mercy, do it cheerfully." And so let's start with the word.